And as we go to the tape now, you can see this great crowd. And believe me, Alabama fans, it is a major emotional impact on our players when we do begin to play well, when we do run on the field, to have those stands absolutely packed for this kind of game. They're just running through us, not very encouraging there in the early part, and they made yards. We did force them to punt the first time, and we got the ball and got sacked on the first snap, which we didn't show here, mercifully. But they got the ball back and moved it down the field, and here's an underthrown deep ball, which is a strategy. Actually, we had the play covered pretty well, but the great quarterback, Brett Farr, for University of Southern Mississippi, made a fine throw, and his receiver made an excellent row, made an excellent adjustment, and they scored to go up 7-0. We finally made a first down there. Collingsworth to Craig Sanderson. Here's Saran Stacy for a few yards. We didn't drive the ball on our very next possession. The tackling began to pick up. Spencer Hammond on that tackle there. And Charles Gardner made a very critical interception for us. Ran it back 28 yards. And on second and six from the 30-yard line going in, Saran Stacy, who had another record-setting day, goes for 23 yards. Real good blocking up front there. Terrell Chapman, Trent Patterson, Roger Schultz, Charlie Abrams. Here on the lead blocks, as Saran Stacy takes it in for the first touchdown. With the extra point at 7-7 on the replay, you'll see Lamon Russell, who had a great day catching the ball, make a key block here. The same people up front, led by Martin Houston, who he doesn't really drill his guy, but he gets a brush block. Lamon Russell knocks his guy down, and we go in the end zone, and the score is 7-7. Now with Southern Miss with the ball back, they move the ball. They gain a lot of yards passing on us. And I was really impressed with the capacity of Favre to move around like this, to keep himself up on his feet. He made that throw. That might have been a nice game for them, but Warnsley couldn't hang on. Here, good hard running by Warnsley. But again, we're hitting a little bit better at this point. McCants and Holbrooks on that tackle. We get the ball back, but we're forced to punt. And the great punt returner, who's just about to break this thing against us, Tony Smith, drops the ball. And Pierre Goode, with his great speed, jumps on it. And so at the end of the first quarter, at 7-7, we've just gotten our second big turnover. And we'll be back to take a look at that after these messages.
And save Auburn and Alabama football trading cards. Find all the 20 from each team at stores all over Alabama. Get details on the remaining 20 at displays of Coca-Cola Classic.
We're in the second quarter now with a score 7-7. A second down at the 9-yard line. Real good tackling by Southern Mississippi. They were tough and aggressive all day long. Never gave up. Real impressed with the job that Kelly Hallman's done over there. Of course, they had a great year last year, and they've had injury problems this year. But we kicked the field goal, and as we said, the tackling got much better. I think they ended up with 72 yards rushing, and that was a critical thing on the day. Warnsley, who runs real hard. Good tackles there by Willie Wyatt, George Thornton, Howell at the middle for 3 yards. We get the ball back. Here, Gary Hollingsworth. To Kevin Turner. Kevin makes a good catch for 8 yards there. Third down and 7. Good conversions on third down. Great catch here by Craig Sanderson. What Coach Smith calls the Hamilton connection there. And on the sprint out to John Casimus. John has been a real good worker for us this year. He hadn't gotten as many balls thrown to him as some of the other guys, but he's been a great blocker and a great hustler, and he's there when we need him to catch the ball. And here's the guy who probably had the best game of the day, Lamon Russell, who just continues to make one great play after another for us, week in and week out. One of the truly fine young people and a great football player. And over here, just a great catch. Okay, Hollingsworth now. Again to Lamont, and for the touchdown, a one-handed catch in the end zone. And a chance to see this again, and folks, this is concentration. And I can honestly say we practice one-hand catches, but we don't practice them at that level. Nonetheless, Lamont almost single-handedly, along with Hollingsworth, brings us down the field, and the score is now 17-7. Better pursuit. John Sullins in on a big play there. We're starting to tackle better. And this guy Smith is a great runner, but excellent play at the point of attack by Spencer Hammond. And then Sullins cleaning up. Great hit again by Spencer Hammond. Fellas call him Hammer. And because we're playing it so well at the point of attack, we force Smith to reverse his field, and Willie Wyatt and Steve Webb, who continue to play good football for us, are there to make the play. John Mangum, who was recently named to at least one All-American team. They didn't try John too many times, but he managed to break that one up. Kevin Turner on the draw. Good running. 9 yards there. Great presence by Gary, moving in the pocket, getting rid of the ball, and a short gain as Kevin has good concentration to come back to help. Good throw and catch, and Kevin just keeps running over people, spinning away from tacklers. Does a tremendous job for us. And here under real pressure, we're going down the field now just before the half. This is a drive that consumed 1:27, but we got in 9 plays and traveled 62 yards to set up the field goal. Saran carries it down close, and Phillip comes on to make the score 20-7. And I do know that Lamon Russell is from Aniona, and it escaped me a minute ago, and I'm getting a little heat from the peanut gallery here behind the camera, but we do know where our players are from, and all the folks over in Aniona are certainly a proud of Lamont. We'll be back with the second half after these messages.
Hi, I'm Eli Gold, and to me, there's nothing quite as exciting as broadcasting a Crimson Tide victory on a crisp fall afternoon.
You can support the Crimson Tide by purchasing officially licensed Alabama souvenirs. When you see this label, you know you can be sure of the quality and that a portion of the proceeds will go to support the university's academic scholarship program and the Paul Bryant Museum.
So show your Crimson pride by purchasing only the officially licensed Alabama souvenirs.
We're starting the third quarter now. The score is 20-7, and Gene Jelks returns it. People are really smart. They pop the ball up and get good hang time so that we can't really organize our returns the way we'd like, but we get it back up around the 30-yard line, which is a decent field position to start. Good throw and catch there. And guess who? Lamon Russell making a great catch in traffic. Good work on Warnsley there against the running game, which, as I mentioned, was very important to us. And we sort of rock back and forth, swap possessions. Martin Houston off the right guard for 5 yards, and this big guy continues to be a real factor. He's hit at the line of scrimmage, but he's run away from people and through people, securing the football. Joe Demos in the game now. Trent Patterson got nicked, but should be okay. Chris Robinette also was slightly injured, but we think he'll probably be all right, too. And we're going right back down the field now. Greg Sanderson on the catch for 15 yards. And our offensive captain, Marco Battle, good job on the sideline there, a 7-yard gain. And Philip Doyle comes on to make the field goal. And so we go up by 23-7, and Philip set a new school record with 20 field goals on the season. He is now 20 out of 22. And if there's somebody better than that in the United States, I would love to know who that is. Ephraim Thomas with a great play on the out cut. We get the ball back. Here's Derek Lasser, who's doing a terrific job for us in the backup tailback spot. Excellent catch there. We're on 3rd and 17. It's a shovel pass. Derek comes up the pipe. And good, tough running. 17 yards on the first down. Second and six. Prince Wembley on the catch. And you'll notice that a large number of our receivers are getting the ball thrown to them and are doing a good job. Marco Battle again. And here on third and four, we run the sweep. And the blocking is just excellent. Lamon Russell again. Vince Strickland. Charlie Dare, I believe, is in the game by this time. No, Chris Robinette's still there. Charlie came on and did a good job for us when Chris was injured. I guess that was a little bit later. Martin Houston, excellent job. Knocks one down into the pile. And Saran, with his great acceleration, is able to score. And that breaks Bobby Humphrey's record. That was Saran's 18th touchdown. That was a 75-yard drive and 11 plays. So that the score is now 30-7 with the extra point. Alan Ward kicks off. Alan's a fine kicker. He just happens to be located on a team with a great kicker. Darren Greenwood knocked that football loose. William Hamelong came up with it. And so we've got the ball back. And again, as I mentioned, some of our young people, Craig Harris in the game, doing a good job. And Craig has earned the right to play. Donnie Finkley made that catch. Here on the naked boot, Brian Stutson from Birmingham. Good job in securing the football for us. And the third quarter ends with the score 30-7, and we're threatening again. We'll be back in just a minute. We're third and three at the three-yard line now, and I don't even have to tell you who catches this touchdown pass the way this game is going. Doesn't seem to matter if it's in traffic or if he's hit or if people are around him. Lamon just hangs on. Excellent throw by Gary Hollingsworth. This is the bootleg. Joe Demos out leading. Roger Schultz in there. Vince Strickland doing a good job of protecting. Nice touch by Gary. Good concentration by Lamon. And so that we have now scored 37 consecutive points against a good football team. And I think that's noteworthy. I think our men get their mind on their business extremely well. There's Nelson at left guard, minus 2 yards. George Thornton, Derek Rushton in there making a good play. Here's a reverse. Mike Vermeer, Steve Webb, Keith McCants, Keith Neighbors in there. But they did mount a drive. They had another deep ball on us. As the great quarterback, Favre, was not going to be denied all day long. And they ran that one in there for the touchdown. Lee Osmond with a good tackle as they've got the ball back now. Here John Sellins knocks it loose from Bradley. Ephraim Thomas comes up with it, and we've got the turnover. So ran Stacy for three here. And we ran for a couple of first downs here, running out the clock. Here's Charlie Dare doing an excellent job. Dave Lenore in the game at tight end. A lot of people getting to play, and that's another real good feature of this football game. A lot of young people that have not been in games before had a chance to get on the field at Bryant Denny. There's a 50-yard punt by Bill Smith. Darrell Pickett with the catch, or rather with the tackle. Excellent job, and here's Robert Jones in at tailback showing some good running. Robert's worked very hard to get himself in shape. And you get a chance to see some of our future here with Antonio London on the hip, knocking the ball loose. And that's the last one that we've got to show in action.